Welcome, and thanks for joining us to discuss the San Bernardino International Airport and efforts to revamp the former Norton Air Base. I'm Duane Gang from the Press Enterprise and PE.com. The Norton Air Force Base closed in 1994 with the loss of 10,000 jobs to the region. Since then, local elected officials have worked to redevelop the base. The San Bernardino International Airport Authority is trying to attract commercial airline service and has undertaken an effort to build a passenger terminal and other facilities. But the costs have skyrocketed. The terminal project was set to cost $38 million, but now has grown to more than $100 million. One man, Scott Spencer, has been put in charge of most of the airport's construction efforts. And a recent grand jury report strongly criticized the airport authority for the costs and how it has overseen the work. Joining me now is Press Enterprise business reporter Kim Pearsall, who has been all over this story. Kim, thanks for joining us today.
No problem.
Let's start by having a little bit of background. What is the airport trying to accomplish here?
Sure, the airport is trying to make itself into a commercial airport along the lines of an Ontario airport or a Long Beach airport or Burbank, et cetera. They right now have four gates at their passenger terminal, mm-hmm. and they have all the fixings. They have the baggage claim area, they have the jetways, et cetera.
Right.
They just don't have a commercial airline.
Right.
They're also trying to, they've already achieved building a luxury FBO, a fixed base mm-hmm. operator, mm-hmm. and so that's for general aviation flights. And in this circumstance, business, charter flights, individual flyers who just happen to want to fly around right. Airport to airport.
Now, is that up and running?
That's up and running, and that's been up and running for several months now, and they had a grand opening, they've been doing business, they've been touting the fact that they've sold 600% more fuel mm-hmm. than they had before they were there, and this is the millionaire operation that's
right.
there.
Right. Commercial airline service, though, is kind of the centerpiece. It's something that the city and local elected officials have kind of pursued and touted for a long period of time. And in order to attract an airline, you got to have a terminal. A couple of years ago, I toured the terminal, and there's, baggage claim is there. The arrival and departure of monitors are there. There's even voices saying, don't leave your bags unattended. What's the latest on the construction effort, and is that terminal up and ready to host an airline if they are able to attract one?
Well, it's interesting. I just toured it this past week, and from the way you describe it, it's still almost in the same identical shape as it was a couple years ago. And so they've been talking about getting a commercial airline since 2007, and that's partly the reason and what's mentioned in a civil grand jury report that was released June 30th. They mentioned that they had to move quickly on this terminal because they had a commercial airline that was ready to move in back in 2007. And so they had to move quickly, and that commercial airline never signed on. Well, every several months or so, they've come back and said, we've got a commercial airline, they're going to come in, et cetera. And nothing has ever happened. And what's interesting and noted in the grand jury report is that as auditors from the grand jury were interviewing the executive director and so forth, they even said that, oh no, we'll have a commercial airline signed up mm-hmm. before the grand jury report even comes mm-hmm. out. So between March and June, they expected to have a commercial airline.
Right. Well, let's talk about the cost a little bit. $38 million was the initial kind of cost for this terminal. It has now skyrocketed to more than 100. What's the latest cost figures, and what are some of the reasons that contributed to such a huge increase?
Right, and I'll separate it out a bit because the terminal, the passenger terminal, which we're seeing pictures of right now with mm-hmm. the baggage claim area and mm-hmm. so forth, that was expected to cost $38 million. And so that's what was pitched originally to the Airport Authority mm-hmm. Board to approve, was $38 million, and it's steadily increased from there. There's the other piece, which is the fixed-based operation, which is partly up and running. So mm-hmm. that's the millionaire terminal. Mm-hmm. It's also two hangars that are nearby that still haven't been fully completed. And then there's also a customs building. So this U.S. customs building, which has now grown to a three-story structure that's going to house TSA and customs, that's also under construction now. The fixed base operation, mm-hmm. that was supposed to be $7 million. Mm-hmm. So all in all, 2007, you're starting with a budget basically of $45 million. That has grown now, both projects, to a total of $142.5 million, and they're not finished yet. They still have quite a bit of work to do on the customs building, and they still have work to do on the hangars. Inside the terminal, which I just toured this week, there's still a space for where the concessionaire, mm-hmm. Hudson Group, which has already signed on mm-hmm. to the airport once they get an airline, there's a empty space there where they'll build their restaurant.
And that's the company that runs all the newsstands and Hudson News, and you'll see at
Correct.
Airports across the country.
Right.
Right. Let's talk a little bit about the person that's kind of been in charge of these construction efforts and some of the redevelopment of the base, a gentleman named Scott Spencer. Tell us a little bit about his background and how long he's kind of been working and why the Airport Authority decided to go with him.
Right. Well, he's been at the airport for quite some time, for several years. Going back to his distant background, he was always interested in airlines mm-hmm. and operating airlines and so forth. What got him in trouble is that he had taken over Braniff Airlines, mm-hmm. which was an airline that had been around for quite some time, then went bankrupt, and then he came right. in
And when you're saying trouble, Scott Spencer has had some legal troubles over the years, including spending some time in federal prison related to some of his airline activity, correct?
Exactly. When he took over Braniff Airlines out of bankruptcy, he ran it into bankruptcy again, and then the third time that they tried to revive Braniff Airlines, Department of Transportation said, in no way, shape, or form should Scott Spencer be involved in this airline. Well, when it was found out that he was involved with this third incarnation of Braniff Airlines, that's when the Department of Transportation stepped in, and the federal prison sentence was for bankruptcy fraud. Mm-hmm. And so he served, I think he was sentenced to 51 months. It's, I believe, unclear as to how many months he actually served in prison, but he was sentenced to 51 months in federal prison for bankruptcy fraud. And later, after that, he started an airline called Ascend Aviation. Mm-hmm. And so he brought that to San Bernardino Airport. So that was his first involvement right. with San Bernardino Airport. The Department of Transportation stepped in because he was essentially running the charter airline without a license. Mm-hmm. And that's when the Department of Transportation said in, I believe, September 2004, that he should not be operating an right. airline, and he was essentially banned from aviation.
And we should note that he is appealing some of these FAA decisions.
But the order still stands.
Okay.
So even while he's appealing it, the order, the federal order from the Department of Transportation that barred him from aviation and air transportation activities still stands.
Right. Let's move on to the grand jury report. What were some of its key findings? It seemed like they were pretty critical of the Airport Authority for how it oversaw some of the finances and oversaw some of these contracts. If there's one or two things to kind of pick out and that viewers and readers should know most about what the grand jury kind of found, what are some of the key findings that they concluded?
Well, the big focus and what we were talking about just now is Scott Spencer. Mm-hmm. So essentially, he came to the airport with Ascend Aviation and started that, got in trouble with it again, actually owed the airport money for that charter airline service, paid back the airport, and then started renting a hangar mm-hmm. at the airport. One of the largest hangars there. And so he basically went from renting a hangar, which he still does, he's the master landlord of that hangar for a big portion of it, went to being the master developer for both the terminal and then the FBO project. So mm-hmm. those are both agreements that were signed in 2007. No bids were put out for those lease agreements. So those lease agreements essentially gave him the right to occupy those spaces while developing those spaces. And so since 2007, he's been doing that. And what the grand jury report mentions is that, or at least pins on Scott Spencer, is that his forecast for passenger numbers at the airport is why the number increased from 45 million for both the FBO and the terminal project to now 142.5 million.
Now, didn't the grand jury raise some questions or raise some concerns that part of the income that Scott Spencer and his companies receive is kind of a percentage of the overall construction contract? So some people might say, well, he has an incentive to have the costs go up because that means he will get more money. They responded to some of those accusations.
And in regards to that, he does get 1.35% of every construction contract for one of the agreements, and then mm-hmm. he gets 2% of each contract for the other agreement. The authority and officials, airport officials, especially Executive Director Don Rogers and mm-hmm. San Bernardino Mayor Pat Morris, who is on both boards, San Bernardino Airport Authority as well as the IBDA,
right.
which funds the airport, have both said that these weren't profitable contracts for Scott Spencer, that 1.35% of each contract, construction contract, and 2% of each construction mm-hmm. contract are modest compared right. to other agreements. And so they're saying that these weren't very lucrative agreements.
Right. We should note that the local elected officials have kind of really kind of pushed back a little bit on, or quite a bit on, this grand jury report. They've considered it filled with inaccuracies. And the issue came up at a recent San Bernardino International Airport Authority board meeting where Supervisor Josie Gonzalez, San Bernardino County Supervisor, serves on on the board, and she had some interesting things to say about the grand jury report and the agency. We're going to take a look at a few of those clips. Let's take a look at clip one.
We must include affirmation of findings that accurately identify problems within the agency. Because do they exist? Yes. Nothing's perfect. Everything can always be improved upon. And this agency and the findings of the grand jury are no different.
What are some of the problems that she's kind of alluding to here? Is she talking specifically kind of about the grand jury report?
Right. The grand jury report makes quite a few recommendations. And so she admits to the fact that there are deficiencies in this agency, as well as any other agency. And she goes on to say that no agency is perfect. But it is telling that she said flat out that there are deficiencies that they should admit to, because quite a few other officials with the airport, the staff, management, so forth, have pinpointed specifically the errors that are in the grand jury report or errors that they're reading in the grand jury report.
Mm-hmm. Let's take a look at a second clip from what Supervisor Gonzalez had to say.
There will be some very strong recommendations that will be coming from me publicly. I'm sure that the mayor also and other authority members will be included in those very strong public recommendations, uncomfortable ones, difficult ones, but know that as far as I am concerned, I believe that we will be very forthright and upcoming with the acceptance of the changes that need to be made.
It seems that she's kind of making reference that she will be proposing some recommendations. Do we have any idea what she might be recommending?
Correct. She alluded to these strong, uncomfortable, difficult recommendations, but did not make it clear during her 12-minute talk during the meeting mm-hmm. about what exactly those changes are going to be. So it's going to be interesting to see on the horizon
right.
what's proposed.
And she had some pretty strong language at that meeting. Let's take a look at the third clip where she is, you know, kind of really strongly says that changes need to come. Let's take a look.
Individuals who are with the authority and have been with the authority for many years, perhaps from the beginning, that will need to move on.
What was your take? Was that some of the strongest language you've seen from any of the board members in reference to the grand jury report?
It was the first mention I've heard of anyone saying that individuals may need to move on. There are quite a few folks in the agency who have been there for several years, who have been there on a contract basis, who have gotten their contracts renewed every year. And
right.
so for her to say that some may need to move on was interesting.
Mm-hmm. And finally, we're going to take a look at a clip where Supervisor Gonzalez kind of references some of these audits that the airport is supposed to do itself. Let's take a look.
We must disassociate from certain individuals who can bring perhaps a shadow on the viability of the audits that are very important, and we must be able to conduct the competitive procurement process for the auditing of these services.
She doesn't say this by name, but the grand jury report kind of was kind of critical of Executive Director Don Rogers, who once worked with and was a partner with the firm that does the auditing for the San Bernardino Airport. What did the grand jury find there, and did they make some recommendations?
One of the recommendations in particular was about Rogers, Anderson, Malady, and Scott, which is a Redlands-based CPA firm that has been doing the auditing for the airport for as long as I can recall in terms of their records. And it was founded by the current executive director, Don Rogers, I believe way back when, and he's since retired. So he's been retired from that firm for about 12 years. His only connection, he says now, is that he simply rents office space mm-hmm. in their office, but he has no financial connection to them whatsoever. Nonetheless, Rogers, Anderson, Mallody, and Scott have been the primary auditor for all of the capital projects that have been going on at the airport.
It seems that Supervisor Gonzalez may want to have that and that auditing work bid out on a regular basis. So it'll be interesting to see how that unfolds.
Right, and the grand jury actually recommended that auditing firm be rotated every 5 years and that be bid out as soon as possible for this next year.
Right. This, of course, is all aimed at attracting, their work there is all aimed at attracting a commercial airline. San Bernardino Mayor Pat Morris has been kind of pushing and pursuing that ever since his first term as mayor. What's the latest? It seems like every few months, airport officials say we're pretty close. What's the latest? Are we close to getting an airline at San Bernardino?
Well, officials were even telling auditors for the grand jury back in March, like I mentioned, that they would have a commercial airline signed on before the report was released June 30th. That has yet to happen. The latest that we've heard is that they have a letter, and they won't say if it's a signed letter of intent. They won't really describe the details of what it is, but they have a letter from an international airline, a Mexican mm-hmm. airline, to serve the airport.
Right.
So what they've said is that this airline is waiting for the U.S. Customs building to be finished before they'll be able to land.
Right.
We'll see.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how it all unfolds. Kim, thanks for joining us today. And you can read more of Kim's stories on San Bernardino International Airport at pe.com. For the Press Enterprise, I'm Dwayne Gang. Thanks for watching.